B. Kunin mo yung power bank ko. Asan yung charger? Binigay lang niya sa akin, power bank. Tama naman, sabi ko naman kasi power bank. Sobrang ganda. Ito ka nga, pwesto ka tabi ko. Ang ganda ng framing, oh. Say hi. To be honest, I don't know where to start or how to start this vlog. So, hi guys! Welcome back to my channel. And as you can see, this video is kind of peaceful, calm, and relaxing because of my background. And yes, I filmed this in between our Humalig trip. And I don't know, before I went here or before akong pumunta rito, I have this thing in mind. I have this plan in my mind na gusto kong gumawa ng vlog about all the stuff that's messing my brain every time na nandun ako sa Laguna or every time that I'm not here. Well, basically, when I'm in my real life. Anyway, for this video, I wanna talk about my life after graduation. Basically, this video is kinda late for batch 2018, yung batch ko, but it's also kinda early for batch 2019 who will be graduating this March, April, or May, or June. Hindi ko na alam kung kailan kayo gagraduate. But anyway, this video is just about life after graduation. So I'm at that point in my life that I have the existential crisis. Right after graduation, you'll feel that. Mararamdaman nyo talaga na, what's my purpose? Ano nga ba ako after? Ano bang gusto kong gawin? May gusto ba talaga akong gawin? Anong gusto kong patunayan? What is my calling? Lahat ng tanong mo sa sarili mo, matatanong mo yan right after graduation. Siguro naiisip nyo na, I wanna do this, I wanna do that, I wanna be this, and I wanna be that. Na parang, I thought I have it figured out. Yay! But you don't. Life after graduation is not as easy as planning it when you were in college. Way back college, to be honest, I thought I have everything figured out. Akala ko, gagraduate na lang ako. Then, lahat ng plano ko, lahat ng naiisip ko is gonna happen. Or, parang akala ko everything will happen according to my plan. Kapag tinatanong nga nila ako nung college ako, sabi nila, anong plano mo, Nika? Anong plano mo? Anong gusto mong gawin after? And I confidently said sa kanila, I confidently answered them that I wanna do events. I wanna be an events coordinator, events planner. I wanna be like that. I wanna be involved in everything that's all about events. Ewan ko, there's just this thing in me that finds passion in it. But then right after graduation, 5 or 7 days or a week after graduation, nag-start na agad kami sa ABS-CBN. It was really a huge leap. I mean, from my mind na gusto ko mag-events, napunta ako sa pagiging production assistant. It's because, sabi nila, for experience daw. Which is, I think it's true naman. For 3 months, nag-work ako doon until I realized na parang it's not gonna be for me. Kasi it's about my health. I do have scoliosis. Medyo heavy siya physically yung work that my health is always at risk. Kapag graduate ka na guys, it's called adulting. It's not gonna be the real world because it's always the real world. It's adulting. Adulting is bullshit. It's hard. Asan na ako? I got lost kasi naman nagsalita ka.
Adulting.
Hey, oo nga no. Adulting. Adulting. Last night, Andy and I are talking about our passion. And I asked him, anong passion mo? And he answered, hindi niya alam. So, basically, there are a lot of you guys out there na may isip nyo na hindi nyo pa alam yung passion nyo sa buhay or you don't know what you wanna do in your life. Siguro, you'll just find it along the way, along of all your experiences, all of your jobs, and ganon. Lahat ng gagawin nyo sa buhay, it takes time naman to find your passion. And ako, I found my passion. I found my passion in doing this kind of thing. I wanna inspire people. I wanna relate to more people through my videos. I wanna do lots and lots and lots of videos. Pero there are just things that you have to reconsider and to think about. Like, will this give me enough money to pay my bills? Will I be successful in this kind of field? I mean, sometimes it's our passion, pero sometimes it's not for us. Sabi nga nila, let's be practical. Hindi ka mapapakain ng passion mo. And alam mo, I'm happy and I am proud to everyone out there. If you're watching this and nahanap mo na yung passion mo and you are happily doing your passion, so congratulations. Kasi not everyone is like you na mahanap na nila yung passion nila. Alam mo yun, not everyone knows where they're going. And I'm happy if you're that person na alam mo kung ano yung path mo. That you have that one path in your life na gusto mong i-pursue. Na yun yung gusto mo, yun yung mahal mo. At dun ka magiging masaya. And to those like me who are lost, really, really, really lost in life, I hope we all find our passion or our path very soon. I mean, it's just a phase in our life. Chapter nga lang daw yon na lost tayo. And chapter nga lang daw yon na we can't find ourselves. But eventually, we'll be able to find ourselves. Do I make sense here? Do you understand me? Because I can't even understand myself. And if you're gonna ask me, guys, what are my plans? My plans are I need to reconsider my parents' advice to try it and to explore. Because eventually, we'll find our way naman din eh. I'm lost. But I'm hoping that one day I'll be able to find my way back to the right path. And I hope you too will. Pero yun lang. There are just things that we continue praying for. Pero it will not come sooner because we have to trust His timing. And I believe in Him. Now one day He will be giving me all the things that I wanted. All the things that I prayed for. I just have to keep on waiting. Do I make sense here? Ano ba tong video na to? Is it about graduation or being lost? I mean, this is about graduation and about being lost at the same time. I'm just saying everything that's on top of my head right now. Pero one day, we'll have our own timing. We have our own life ahead of us. And it's okay not to be successful at a very young age. I mean, we do have different kinds of definition of being successful. And it's okay to feel lost after graduation. It's okay to not know what you want to do in your life. To not know what path you want to take. To not know what tomorrow brings. That it's okay not to be okay after graduation. Do not pressure yourself. Do not feel intimidated by others. It's okay to feel insecure. It's okay to feel insecure about other people's achievement for as long as you take it as something to inspire you, to make you a better person, and to make you strive harder every single day. It's just a normal thing for us. Just claim it, guys. Now we will be successful. We will be able to travel the world, to inspire people, and to make our parents proud. That's all that matters right now. To make them really, really proud. That's it. Thank you so much, guys, for watching this video. And sana na-relax din kayo sa paligid because it's really, really, really relaxing right now. And yeah, thank you so much, guys, for watching this video. And I see you on my next one. Bye!